Natural hazards are a growing concern for human societies, and climate change is creating even more frequent natural hazards and increase the magnitude of their impact.
There's a lot of disasters happening globally, and they're increasing in strength, in proximity to urban locations, and we're seeing more and more disasters each year.
Floods and fires and other climate-driven events are becoming more and more frequent, more impacting, and we need to cope with this.
So what we know is that hazards exist. The hazard, the risk of a flood, the risk of an earthquake, the risk of a tsunami, the risk of events happening. There's little we can do with that. But by being prepared, we can minimize the impact.
There has been an international initiative for disaster risk reduction since 1980s, and many government, UN organizations, and stakeholders have been working on disaster risk reduction. But the number of deaths or economic damage by the natural disasters have been increasing, especially in the last decades. That's why we really need to work on the disaster risk reduction seriously.
We need to know when we have a special event, what to do about it and how to handle different kind of information.
The information normally is somewhere there. It's just a matter of getting it, collecting it and making sense out of it.
Today is really, I think, the time where information is coming from all kinds of different sources. It's really about finding the best way to merge it together because it's just data. But what is needed at the end is information that is actionable.
iReact builds on several technologies, including mobile applications, social media, augmented reality, and satellite observation.
Looking to get technologies that typically aren't in the hands of responders into their hands so we can expedite response. Even looking at how we can change our operations to help with response, these technologies are being brought to the forefront to not only exponentially help us respond in disasters, but to amplify the response and to save lives.
From the beginning of the project, we had a very clear idea. We wanted to gather all actors involved in the emergency management, collect their ideas, so that we can implement an effective solution that can really help society.
We are right now in the process in a room taking a look at how we can carve that out, envision what responders are looking for information, what citizens need, and how we can empower both citizens and responders to better respond when an emergency strikes.
You always act and react on a way to help people. And that's what I found here, that it's common sense to all the people here. They want to help the people in a dangerous situation.
Listening to colleagues from across Europe and beyond, quickly we have US, and basically seeing how we actually share the same experiences.
And the stories that are coming out of all of these individuals at iReact are really valuable.
We came with a lot of suggestions and a lot of proposals and a lot of solutions. The discussion was very lively. I like the participatory approach. I can only recommend it.
I've learned a lot from the other side, let's say, of the disaster solution perspective.
After these two amazing days of workshop, we are now full of ideas for implementing iReact in a way that will be very effective in helping the society in dealing with natural hazards and making sure they don't become real disasters.